The MKT came before the town did. The Missouri, Kansas, and Texas people were trying to get from up north to Galveston. They were trying to get their goods. And the rail people called it the Katy Rail, kind of where the name Katy came from. Thomas, that was the postmaster, was asked the name of the town when he went to get a post office box. He called it Katy. Katy proper is 11 square miles, roughly give or take. We have our own mayor, our own council members, our ward members, and all that kind of stuff. We can never be incorporated. We are tri-county. We're Waller, Fort Bend, and Harris County. Even in this 11 square miles, we are all three counties.
My job here is to be a steward of the past, a shepherd of the present, and keeper of the future, basically hoping to tell them what life was like around here. I mean, I think a lot of people just have, shunned a lot of this technology. I mean, kids are on their smartphones. They don't have even know that long time ago you had to dial manually, or that we only got three or four channels on the TV instead of gazillions, not to mention the internet or YouTube.
Everybody in Katy at one time had all of these black. I think it gives them a sense of stability in this world that we have right now, which is just kind of like popcorn, to know and to be able to come here and actually touch parts of history that people actually did.
Everybody owned a tractor and everybody played with, used them. I mean, this is a farming community originally. We were known for oil and gas, natural gas and rice. I mean, we're just gonna become one of those little suburbs again, and it's like, we gotta know our heritage. I'm kind of an amateur historian myself. It's kind of a good feeling. As a young man, I'm interested in keeping the past alive and passing it on for future generations.
What would they use to catch all the stuff in the back?
Parents give you roots, they give you wings, and we hope you fly. And we hope you're successful. These are your roots right here.